Hi, and welcome back to a new 3DEqualizer4 tutorial. This video is all about 3DE's new plane constraints feature, shipping with release 7.1. There's a lot to talk about today, so let's get started. Here is a new sequence, shot in our green screen lab. It consists of 35 frames of quite wonky camera movement. Overall, not showing much parallax. As you can see, there are two green screen walls filled with markers which seem to be orientated perpendicular to each other. In addition to that, there is a checkerboard in the middle of the frame. It is somewhat randomly leaning against the wall. The shot has already been tracked, but we have been lazy and only used 3D's auto tracker here. Except for the checkerboard. For it we have 5 manually tracked points at least. As usual, the sequence was shot with our vintage anamorphic lens and we already calculated distortion parameters. The project itself, though, hasn't been calculated yet, so let's quickly calc all from scratch. At first glance, it has successfully run through. There is a deviation of 0.11 pixels and the overall shape of the point cloud looks somewhat fitting for the scene at hand. However, if we look from above, we can see that the points located on the two walls are not orientated perpendicularly to each other. Furthermore, the points which have been tracked on the front-facing wall don't look completely flat either. The left-hand points appear to be bending away to the back. Let's try to adjust focal length in order to improve the situation. For this purpose, we first add 3DE's parameter adjustment window to its pane structure and then set focal length to adjust. Since we have no clue about the lens, we set adjustment range to wide and increase brute force samples to 50. Finally, we activate network calculation in order to speed things up a little and hit adjust. As you can see, the adjustment process found a reasonable minimum at around 40 mm and improved deviation by around 10%. Let's hit calc all from scratch again and check the result. The point cloud now looks more reasonable, since both walls appear to be more perpendicular to each other now. However, it isn't perfect yet, and in addition to that, the left-hand points still look like they're curving towards the back. Let's also quickly check 2D tracking. For this purpose, we select one of the leftmost points and switch to F2. When we zoom in closer to the point, we can clearly see that it hasn't been tracked very well. The point is sliding across its white marker. Damn auto-tracking! Enough with the preparations, though. Now it's time for our first plane constraint. We'll also select the left-hand points using Ctrl-Alt. Then we quickly switch to F2 and check if all selected points are indeed located on the front wall. Yep, looks good. Finally, we create our desired plane constraint through menu, constraints, create, create plane constraints. A small requester pops up asking for an identifier of the to be created constraint. We enter front underscore wall and hit OK. A dark, square-shaped plane object appears in the display area. By default, it is oriented as close as possible around its corresponding 3D points. Plane constraints behave similar to 3D models in 3DE4. They can be selected and modified just as you would expect. For our example, we want the front wall to be oriented exactly parallel to the XY plane. Therefore, we enter 90, 0, and 0 into its rotational text fields. After we calculate all from scratch again, the situation has changed quite a bit. First of all, the whole solve has now been reoriented around our newly created plane constraint and is no longer arbitrarily distributed in 3D space. In addition to that, all points of the front wall have been forced onto the plane constraint, so any bending or noisy positioning is gone. Unfortunately, deviation has gone up by around 100% to 0.19 pixels. Anyway, let's add a second plane constraint for the right-hand wall points. Again, we lasso select the respective points and check in F2 if they are indeed all located on the right green screen wall. Then, we create another plane constraint and name it right_wall. In order to force the right wall points to become perpendicular to their front wall counterparts, we select the plane constraint and enter minus 90, 0 and minus 90 into its rotational text fields. Now, let's calc all from scratch again and check the results. As expected, all front and right wall points have now been forced into a perpendicular situation. Deviation, however, has gone up by nearly 100% again. It is now 3.7 times higher than in comparison to our non-plane constraint version. Let's try to optimize focal length again and see if that has any impact on the solve. Well, yes, it turns out that now we have a clear new minimum around 45.7 millimeters. Deviation is still about 100% higher than originally, though. Once again, let's quickly select the point with the highest deviation in the deviation browser and check its 2D tracking in F2. Yep, auto tracker strikes back. The reason why deviation becomes significantly increased is obviously caused by bad tracking. But in addition to that, this relatively low parallax camera move forces the solver to create an overall distorted point cloud. Once we add the two plane constraints, we force the solver out of its comfort zone and as a consequence, deviation has to go up. Let's continue our project by adding a third plane constraint for the checkerboard points. As mentioned before, the board looks to be oriented quite randomly in 3D space. Unfortunately, that means that this time we can't simply enter its orientation by hand. Instead, let's start by selecting the black center point and creating another plane constraint. We label this one checker. When we now open the constraints tab of the current point group in the object browser, we see that each plane constraint we previously created is listed there. Of course, selection works as you would expect. In addition, the number of associated points of a plane constraint is listed as well. If we right-click on our checker plane constraint and then select script, select link points, all currently associated points become selected. As you can imagine, this can be quite useful in certain situations. Now we want all 5 checkerboard points to be linked to our new plane constraint. So we select the remaining 4 points in the object browser, check in F2 if we have caught the correct ones, and finally select script add points to plane constraint found in the constraints menu. The points become deselected and the object browser now indicates that 5 points have been associated with checker. For a final quick verification, we select script, select link points one more time. Next, we want to orient our plane constraint roughly by hand. For that, we select it and use 3DE scale manipulator to make it a bit bigger in order to improve its graphical representation of the actual checkerboard. And by the way, changing the size of a plane constraint has no effect on calculation. It's just pure eye candy. We now use the rotation manipulator to make it somewhat consistent to the remaining two plane constraints. Matches pretty good already for just a quick and dirty shooting from the hip job, hmm? Let's keep going. After we calc all from scratch, deviation only goes up by 20%. So yes, our dirty eyeballing and adjusting obviously worked. Nevertheless, for precise and stress-free orientation of plane constraints, we developed a new adjustment script. First, we have to select the plane constraint we want to optimize, and then select script adjust plane constraint from the adjustment menu, found in the main window. A new requester window pops up. As usual for these adjustment scripts, it allows you to choose which parameters you'd like to optimize. To be more precise, it is possible to optimize the translation of a plane constraint along its normal. Furthermore, its orientation can be optimized by the help of up to 3 parameters. However, usually 2 parameters are sufficient, since a plane is more or less still just a flat V object. Enough of that, back to our project. For now, we only want to optimize the orientation of our plane constraint in 3D space. So we deselect toggle translate plane along normal and leave all the other ones at default. After hitting OK, 2 new scripting parameters appear in the parameter adjustment window. Since we already roughly pre-aligned our constraint from the hip, we can leave all settings at default and simply hit adjust. The adjustment procedure creates a pleasing, nice-to-look-at distribution of result samples. Obviously, there is a perfect minimum, and because of that, the plane constraint checker can be optimized very well. Finally, deviation goes down to 0.21 pixels, which is an improvement of about 20%. Once we save back the best result into 3DE's database, we can see that our plane constraint is slightly reoriented in 3D space. Again, we calc all from scratch, and now all 5 checkerboard points are forced onto our third plane constraint. So far, so good. Let's now discuss whether such constraints can be optimized within all possible dimensions at all times. For this purpose, we clear the parameter adjustment window, select plane constraint right underscore wall, and then just add its translation parameter to the parameter adjustment window. After hitting adjust, we surprisingly see, well, just a flat line. That means, regardless of the 3D position of constraint right underscore wall, the resulting deviation of our project is always 0.2126 pixels. And as a consequence, its translation cannot be optimized at all. At least, not for this particular project. Let's repeat this experiment. But this time we do it a little differently. We once again clear the parameter adjustment window and add a single rotation parameter through script adjust plane constraint. After hitting adjust, we can see a perfect minimum. So, in contrast to our previous examination, rotation of the same plane constraint obviously can be very well optimized. To conclude our little R&D session, we will finally introduce a few real survey points. First, we select Constraint Checker, right-click in the object browser to open its context menu, and then select Script Constraint Attributes. In the upcoming requester, we can change its name, which we do. In addition to that, we can also define whether it should be taken into account for calculation or not. We disable it for now, and finally hit OK. As you can see, our constraint has disappeared from the display area. In addition to that, it is now being listed as disabled in the object browser as well. Next, let's select all 5 checkerboard points and run script convert to surveyed to nail them down in 3D space. Afterwards, we clear the parameter adjustment window, select constraint right underscore wall, and once again add its translation parameter to the adjustment window. Once we hit adjust, we can see that suddenly a very sharp minimum is visible. Because of that, the 3D position of plane constraint right underscore wall can now, finally and unlike before, be optimized quite well too. In fact, it is not very easy to say in which situations certain plane constraint parameters can be optimized or not. as a rule of thumb, it is safe to say that in survey-free projects containing just a single plane constraint, this plane constraint cannot be optimized at all, since it only defines the orientation of a solve in 3D space. If more than just one plane constraint is available in such a project, it is likely that translation of these constraints cannot be optimized very well, if at all. If survey points are available, however, it's likely that all kinds of plane constraint-related parameters can be optimized well. To conclude our project, we will now try to bring deviation down as low as possible. So, we clear parameter adjustment window one more time and add all translational and rotational parameters of both remaining plane constraints to the adjustment window. In addition, we also add focal length once again. Finally, we set all parameters to adaptive to speed things up a bit and hit adjust. After some extensive data chewing, 3DE is able to reduce deviation from 0.21 to 0.18 pixels. Let's check the result one last time and hit calc all from scratch. The deviation browser still shows some systematic errors due to the bloody auto-tracking. But overall the result doesn't look too shabby. If we look from above though, we can see that one of the walls has slightly rotated, so that both walls are no longer perpendicular to each other anymore. Looks like our office is in a tilted building. So much for that famous German craftsmanship. Let's hope 3DE4 fulfills those expectations at least. Anyway, we hope this tutorial has helped you get around with plane constraints and all the new features that come along with it. Check out our other tutorials related to 3DE4 release 7.1. See you soon!